guys.
Why?
That was gross.
Anyway, Austin and I were talking the other day, and we wanted to start doing a little mini series, basically, about kind of talking about lyrics in different songs. I don't think we're going to just stick to just one genre. We're going to do multiple genres. So that's a thing, because we all listen to different shit. What we're going to do today is we're going to do Slipknot's Welcome off of Volume 3 of the Subliminal Verses. Personally, one of my favorite bands.
Really dope band.
And these are all just opinions. We're going to dissect lyrics from songs and basically try to understand what they're trying to say. We chose a pretty difficult one for this one, only because on the Subliminal Verses by Slipknot, there was really no real true descriptions of what the songs were saying or what they meant or anything like that by the bands or anything like that. That's why it is the Subliminal Verses. And there are songs that don't really... They're kind of how you take them. They're written in a way for you to be able to basically take it as you wish. If that's how it made you feel, then that's how it made you feel. That's not on them. Have you heard this song?
I have not.
You haven't heard this song. Have you heard this
song? Well, I may have. It's been a very long time since I've heard Volume 3 in its entirety.
Came out in 2004. So.
I was 11.
I was 14.
75.
I was 14.
He was 30.
I was 14. Fuck.
Austin was 25.
Hannah was just being born. So, she grew up very, very fast. She has a disease.
Progeria.
They have far to get. I mean, I'm sure. So it's pretty quick.
So here we have the lyrics for Welcome. It's the seventh track off that album. So I'm going to read some of it to the best of my abilities, and we're going to try and dissect it. We're going to stop and go and stop and go. So as an intro, that is an intro to this whole entire series. You'll see the title, and we'll figure out what the fuck it's called later. But,
Perception, interpret... No,
I don't fucking know.
Stop coming to me with names. I'm shitty at names. And we keep.
I'll name it. I'll figure it out. Here we go. But for this dissection, the way that they do the song, it's not like actual verse, chorus. It's weird how they wrote this album. But for this song specifically, there's sections of the verse.
Specifically.
So the song starts off, I am a product of your conduct. The uncontrollable urges that made me and have made us all. Are you proud? Do you even care? You taught us all a lie. That's how we made it here. You should have buried the truth with your secrets, but you were far too impressed with your pretense. Now, as far as I know, I don't know anything, because you made damn sure I wasn't anything. Distractions, reactions, the only way to go is to go away. Discarded, retarded, before I let you go, you have to let me. Now, from there, from that portion of the song, what do you guys think it would mean?
I think the first part of the song, it was like saying, I'm a product of your conduct and stuff like that. I personally think of maybe a kid who was brought up in a dysfunctional home and doesn't know how to act properly in society due to his upbringing. He or she. I'm not sexist. Because we can both be equally fucked up. What do you think?
I think, like, in a more, like, general idea, that it's talking about how everyone has this vision of how you should be and how you're supposed to act and what your life is and what is a happy life. And I think it's saying, like, well, look, like, we all have these fucked up things about us. Like, we're all different in our own way. And yet, do you even care about my individuality? Do you even want to know about it? Or am I just supposed to carry on the lie that was given to me? Like, oh, you just ignore that. You're not supposed to be like that. This is what society wants you to be. And I think they're realizing, like, well, I'm apart from society. I'm different than what the world thinks should be popular. My likes are different. And they're realizing that. And so that's my perspective.
I think it's more, in my opinion, I think it's more of a fact of being, an like you said, an individual, but also coming and stemming, kind of merging the two and stemming from the fucked up nature of being brought up in a society where you're supposed to only follow one path and there is only one way to go. I have some of those opinions, but some of those ways that I think are that way. Like, you're supposed to graduate high school. You're supposed to get that stuff finished. That's a thing that just is. It's not a thing that should be celebrated. Your birthday is going to come around. You should be able to celebrate it because you made it to the next one. But also, like, in a sense, for this, people being condescending to this person based on what they like. Whether it is, like you said, their individuality and what music they like, what clothes they like to wear, what they look like, how they look, how they act, if they're quiet when everybody else is being loud, and things of that nature. I think that's a big thing about it. What their sexual desires are, what they basically want out of life, and what they want to do to be happy isn't what's actually making the other people in their life happy. So...
And especially, like, that part where it says you should have buried the truth with your secrets, but you were too far impressed with your pretense. Like, it's like, oh, so this is my truth, but really it's me hiding things, and it's to paint this picture of what everyone else should think I am, but in reality you have all these lies and everything that you're trying to hide, and it's like, okay, well... Now, I don't even know who you are because I'm figuring this out. So now I don't even know who I am because I was basing everything off of what you were telling me. And
yeah.
So now it's like, well, fuck. Like, I don't know.
like that part to me, like as the kids would say nowadays, I think they found out somebody they probably looked up to or was condescended toward, like that was talked down from. This person... was a fake ass bitch, as the kids would say. And now they're realizing that, and yeah,
it was like fabricated, kind of like reality TV.
Yeah, like the Jersey Shore man
and shit like that. And shit that like shows on MTV a lot of the time, as of recently, even in the last decade, that it's been fabricated. That the reality shows are fabricated. That they are fake, and you're hiding a reality. You're hiding. You're making it look like it's real, but in reality, it's fake and stuff of that nature. So, okay. I think we can all agree to disagree on that section.
Yeah.
Like you can't hide the truth forever.
Yeah. So, we're going to move on to the next portion of the song. So, the next part says, clawed away from human clay, we are the broken shards, the art disarray. Before you condemn, you rape them, feed us meconium. Stunt our growth... from our souls to our throat, you shouldn't wall us up with your apathy. But you did, and now you're only growing enemies. This is the catalyst, the alpha, the first breed, because you made damn sure now we're everything. Distractions, reactions, the only way to go is to go away. Discarded, retarded, before I let you go, you have to let me. Much to my surprise, I will wake up and follow the path of the ones I am made of. This time I won't give in. I will save you from my sins. What is wrong with this manipulation, violence, and chaotic? So from there, what do y'all think it is?
For these portions right here, from the clawed away to the before I let you go, you have to let me. I think at that point, this person has had enough and is like, you know what, fuck you, I'm gonna do what I'm gonna do. And like saying that weird, like the broken shards, the art disarray, like making the claim that I'm fucked up, there's a lot of other people like me that are fucked up, and we're kind of rising up, and we're not gonna take your shit anymore. And this is all your fault for pushing us down, because you can only push somebody so far before they finally snap.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree with that. And I'd just like to add, like, where is it? Yeah, but you did, and now you're only growing enemies. And it's, I think that part is probably the one that stuck out to me most, just because it's this attitude that they had. It was this way of showing that person, and they were being selfish, and just, it was all about them, to where everyone else was noticing it, and it was, they're creating enemies, they're not creating friends, they're not controlling anything, they're isolating themselves. And when you have an attitude like that, like, you're keeping secrets, you're hiding things, but you're putting yourself above everyone else, you begin to put a distance between people. And it was like, look, you put yourself on this pedestal, and you're not, you ain't shit.
We're here to knock you the fuck down, son.
Essentially, so,
fight me, you cheeky scrub.
That's kind of the way that I see it, in a more so involved way, I guess, is like, from clawed away from the human clay, we all come from the same place. Mm-hmm. We all have our ancestors. We all have a beginning of the human existence, essentially. Going, kind of thinking of it more philosophically, going back all the way to when we came from this other creature over time, and things have branched out, and we have the different races, we have the different skin tones and skin colors for this reason, that reason, and that reason, that because we all came from that ancient ancestor, that is the human, that's the human clay, the primordial ooze, I guess you would say, in the terms of scientific evolution. We are the broken shards, the art disarray, meaning to me that we all are different. Despite the fact that we are the same, we are different, because every time that you break something, like whenever something has a crack, each crack is going to be a little bit different, but they're going to have the same, they cause the same purpose. Mm-hmm. So that's my take on that. And then before you condemn, you rape them. You don't even give them a chance to say their piece, but you automatically just push them to that point where you're not even going to try to listen to my side. You're just going to push them away just because they look weird, act weird. They have different tastes and stuff like that from the previous part, or the previous verse, you should say. Mm-hmm. And then you constantly, whenever they say fetus meconium is like the first shit, I think, if I remember correctly, that a baby has after they're born. So it doesn't, it's just like calcium and shit that they digest as they're in the womb and shit. So that's what that is. So you're feeding us bullshit or shit to believe whatever it is that you want us to believe, and want us to know whatever it is that you want us to know, without us having our own thought process. And by that goes into the whole, like, stunt our growth from the souls to our throats, meaning that what we feel and what we're supposed to know, you want us to believe one thing instead of believe another, despite the fact that we know for a fact that this is how it is. This is the human existence. And as a whole, for the last part, where it goes from, you shouldn't wall us up with your apathy, but you did, and now you're growing enemies, is basically that these people are finally sick and tired of their shit, like they both said, of getting to a point where they're gonna fight back.
Yeah.
They're gonna come and they're gonna say, this is it. I don't need the catalyst. This is the catalyst, the alpha, the first breed. We created it. We are who we are. You're gonna deal with what we have to say, and you're gonna deal with what we have to do.
Yeah.
In this life that we all get to live. Mm-hmm. It's not somebody else's choice for them to be killed, for them to have their life ended, basically, because of the way that they are, because of the skin color, whatever race you are, because we're all from the same thing. We all come from the same beginning, is the way that I see it.
Yeah. And then, like, the very end, where it's like, I will wake up and follow, much to my surprise, I will wake up and follow the path of the ones I am made of. This time I won't give in. I will save you from my sins. And I think it's like that part, he's declaring, like, okay, look, I understand what you've done, and I'm not going to make that same mistake. And I'm surprised, but I am going to be who I want to be. And I'm not going to force my mistakes and secrets on you and make you feel less of a person because you make different mistakes. Mm-hmm. So it's, I think that part is a really good like turning point where it's just like, okay, this is all that you've done to me, but I am no longer going to carry that on.
Mm-hmm. And with that part, I'm thinking like along the same lines as you, but a little bit different. Like to me at that point, he realizes that that one day he will be where the people for him were, as in he will be that authority figure. He will be that parent, uncle, you know, whatever authority figure you want to put in that place. And to me, he's saying one day I will be in that place, but I'm not going to do what you did. I'm going to make sure that what you did to me does not happen to the ones that come after me. Mm-hmm. Like, I will let them express themselves. I will let them do whatever they want to do, because there's certain things you shouldn't fucking do, like drugs and murder and stuff. Mm-hmm. But being that
don't
way, as
babies.
In, like, I'm not going to be a fucking complete dickhead like you were. I'm going to let them express themselves.
Like, much to my surprise, I will wake up and follow the path of ones that I am made of. So, yeah, essentially the way that I see it, too, is that as eventually this person's going to get to a point where they're going to be the one that's going to be the leader of the pack, I guess you should say. The one that's going to be in the forefront of everything. And they're going to be the ones that are going to go, that are going to be able to pass on the story from one person to another, as they did back in the day. I will not let you go through the same shit that I had to go through to get to this point. Because that is the way that we're supposed to evolve as a species, is that we're supposed to be able to get better at being people. What is wrong with this manipulation, violence, and chaotic? It's more of a sub-thought of why are people doing this in other places? If we're all the same, then why are things changing so drastically for other groups? And it's... to get to this point, it is a violent and chaotic ride. As, I mean, it's that I think is straightforward in this whole entire portion. Now for the next part, ensconed in all that's wrong, I slam you shut. I can only take so much. How many times do I have to mistreat you? Constantly biting of the hand of my hand as I feed you. That's what I was supposed to say. Maybe now you'll understand severity. I'll sum it up with the best amount of brevity. Welcome to the transformation. Welcome to annihilation. Welcome to the man that wanted everything but couldn't have it. Distractions, reactions, the only way to go is to go away. Discarded, retarded. Before I let you go, you have to let me be. So, or let me.
I'm gonna take a pause real quick. John, you gotta breathe.
We're good.
You didn't breathe. You lied to your watch.
I did lie. I didn't even do it.
Fucking breathe.
Okay. I'll breathe when my watch tells me to breathe.
So, jokes. For this portion, I'm gonna start this one off because I think this one's pretty interesting. I think this is that initial, final, fuck it, essentially, of... I am everything that was done wrong in the past, and by doing wrong, by that wrong thing being done to me, I now have to push forward and go through this, as it said, transformation of getting done. Which word?
Why'd you sell her out, man?
No, I'm just at which word?
Concise and exact use of words in writing or speech. Shortness of time. So the best amount of brevity. Oh, okay, so in such a small amount of time.
Yeah, in the shortest amount of time possible. There is... look up ensconed.
Stab yourself against my... break yourself against my stones. That's what it was. What does that mean? His balls, Taylor.
Establish or settle in a comfort, safe, or secret place so you can be comfortable or settle with someone.
Okay, comfortable in all the wrong, in all that's wrong. Okay, so that's where I was going with it. basically, he's officially at that point where he's finally gonna go, he or she is gonna go, fuck it. I'm sick and tired of these people doing this shit, because I am lower on the totem pole doesn't necessarily mean that I'm not gonna take what's mine. So, welcome to the transformation, welcome to annihilation, welcome to the man that wanted everything but couldn't have it. That is, in itself, the whole entire thing of him going, I will fight tooth and nail until I understand and defeat these people that have treated me like shit all this time. And it's going to take less time for me to get this done than it will for them to ruin my life tenfold, basically.
Mm-hmm.
And then the last part of the song is distractions, reactions. We already said that one. And then much to my surprise, I will wake up and follow the path of the ones I have made of. This time I won't give in. I will save you from my sins, save you from my sins, save you from my sins. It said three times. So, thoughts?
Pretty much the same as what you said. I probably wouldn't have put it as eloquently. I would have been like, this motherfucker he's mad, man. He's fighting.
Yeah, and it's like, how many times do I have to mistreat you? Constantly biting of my hand as I feed you. I think that's a saying that a lot of people use, you know, don't bite the hand that feeds you. And he's in this place, and unfortunately, sometimes your comfort zone can be places that you're uncomfortable with or that other people see as mistreat, but it's all you've known. It's how you grew up. It was your life, and you don't know anything other than that. And you have this picture of what your life could have been or what you want, but I think some people get stuck in the place of where they were born, and they have that mindset like, oh, you were born in poverty. You'll never become middle class or even higher class. And it's like, you know, that's a struggle that many people face, and they feel like they're in this rut because they just can't get out. And they're constantly going around wanting this other life, and they just can't.
Yeah.
And it's like, look, like, I'm trying to deal with the hand that was dealt with me, and I'm trying to show you what you've been doing, but you still aren't getting it because that's your comfort zone too. That's all you've known. And I think that's pretty much what it's saying to me, is just, hey, like, I have this picture of what it could be, but this is where I am. This is how I'm comfortable. I don't know anything else. And how do I move away from that when that's all I know?
I think as the whole entire song, I think this is going to sound like, probably it's a super deep meaning, but I think it's just, as the human existence, who gives a shit about anything else? We are who we are. You shouldn't be able to be pushed away from those feelings or thoughts or ideas or anything. Progress is progress, and you shouldn't try to hold people down because of progression. That goes for every stem of everything,
mm-hmm.
in every way, shape, or form. We shouldn't... It's kind of weird how timely this is working out with the way things are going now in our country with people. And our government and things of that nature, it's essentially the same thing as they shouldn't continue to oppress the people of the country by brainwashing them to believe a certain way. And then those people who don't believe that or don't think that way, they're looked at as crazy, despite the fact that they know what they know is true or right.
Yeah, like seen as crazy, anti-American, anti-freedom, blah, blah, blah. As soon as you don't disagree with somebody, you're automatically the worst of the worst in their opinion.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And I think, let the gays get married, let the women have abortions, let fucking people have 14 dogs. I don't care. Like, it doesn't matter. Let whoever and whatever they want to believe.
Is the 14 dogs thing like an actual issue right now?
No, I don't know. Spay
new
to your pet.
Confused the
spay new to your pet.
Fuck you, Bob Barker. Anyway, we're not going to get on that.
Can't teach your pets about safe sex, so just... Spare neuter
him. Because fucking, I'm not even going that rant right now. Not even gonna go.
It's like in the Eminem song, you're gonna pay $300 to get your pit bull an abortion. You have to throw that shit in the fucking blender. And make some fucking dog salsa out of it.
My salsa makes all the girls want to dance.
But also, why,
my salsa.
Why I said the salsa. Dogs thing, but like, I hope that there is no deep meaning to this song. If we go, hey, like Corey
it's
Taylor,
the knot. It's the knot, man.
Like motherfucker, if I fucking tweet you the video that we just made, this one right here. If we tweet you this video, and you fucking sit through the whole entire thing. Probably 15 so minutes of this whole entire thing of us analyzing your lyrical capabilities and what it's about. I hope it's about a dog. I honestly hope it's about training a fucking dog, other than the deep meanings that we were giving to it. Because if it was,
how
I'd still be happy.
How did you get training a dog out of the
like,
meanings we just talked about?
Because out of everything, like, out of everything.
Hold on, speedrun it. Speedrun us why you think this is about
why,
a dog.
Why I think it's about a dog? Speed because run. Of all of it. So, like...
Because of all.
Because of the whole entire thing. This is my whole theory about the whole deep meaning and everything. That's awesome. Like I believe that. But I hope he says something simple as, "It's about a dog. It's about my dog and fucking having my dog. Like welcome to owning
potty training his child.
Like that or potty or a dog. Because like
I'm trying to feed you. Why
I am
you
a product. I'm the reason why you are here. Basically, I'm a product of your conduct, the uncontrollable urges that have made us and made us all.
Sex.
Are you proud? Do you even care? You taught us all a lie. That's how we made it here. So, like, basically, you should have buried the truth. It is he caught his dog doing something wrong, like burying a fucking bone in the backyard, and his dog is basically like super hyperactive. That's why he's fucking distracted and fucking all over the place, and then
I, like, peed on his Xbox.
Kind of just have to let him be, let the dog be. You love the dog, but you're mad because it happened.
I thought you were man's best friend.
And then because of that, that's where you're clawed away from the human clay. You basically, we molded and we breed dogs left and right to make them be who we are, what we want them to do, what breeds and shit like that. And basically, they're kind of broken because they're crazy and they're hyperactive. And all in all, it all came down to one of the lines where he was basically stating, don't bite the hand that feeds you. Dogs are pretty fucking happy, nonetheless. They love you no matter what.
The catalyst, the alpha, the first breed.
You are the one that is taking care of it. You are their god. They don't believe in a god. They are your god. You are their god. You believe that you are the one that is supposed to take care of them. You are seen as a god by them because you live four times as long as they do. Shit like that. Like, that's why I was like, it's about a dog. It's got a... I hope he says it's about a dog. Because, like, dogs don't have the cognitive thought to be able to process religion. So the thing that they see is the human, who is the thing that can live forever in a day. And it is the first breed that they know of. They exist because of the humans.
Okay.
They're also dying because of the humans.
There's so many, though. But
people everywhere, don't breed your dogs in your backyard.
Mr. Taylor, if you could also tell us if you found those shoes.
Where'd you get those shoes?
And did you stop hyperventilating?
Anyway, for the love of God, I hope this is... Okay, so all the deep meaning that we put on it, everything, I hope that's what it's about. But there's a side of me that's also saying, please say it's about your dog. Just to fucking... Don't say it just because I said you to say it. But, like, what is it about? Let us know. If we ever get anybody to watch this shit, leave a comment on what you
Hopefully,
think this song is about.
Eventually. When we stop sucking.
Stuff like that. So.
Or let us know we suck. Constructive criticism. Okay?
And everything. So.
Can always get better.
Yes,
Thank you for joining
us
on this nameless show that I will not name because I'm sucky at names. And yeah.
Why don't we just call it Nameless?
Isn't that a song?
Yeah.
By Slipknot?
Yeah.
That's funny.
The Nameless, actually.
The Nameless.
Isn't it on this album?
Yeah.
The Nameless.
Did you know that, Hannah?
No, I didn't.
Did you do that on purpose?
I said it earlier before we were recording. I said we should try this one
Hold on.
Maybe it was
Did
like
you say this on purpose? Did you do this to Hannah?
No, I think it was like subconsciously. I don't really know what is stored in my brain. And sometimes when I talk, it just happens to work.
Sometimes my words are good.
Yes. And other times they just make absolutely no sense at all.
Okay, bye guys.
Bye.
Bye.
Who's gonna turn off the camera?